Behavioral Neuroscience, Chapter 15, Segment 2, pages 476 to 490. Facial expressions are mediated by muscles, cranial nerves, and central nervous system pathways. Facial muscles have several purposes, including facial expressions. They can be divided into two categories: superficial facial muscles, which attach to the skin. Of the entire complex. certain stimulus from several brain regions. Information about certain stimulus from several brain regions reaches the lateral portion of the amygdala first. Evidence suggests that neurons in the lateral portion of the amygdala encode association between specific stimuli and adverse events. The lateral amygdala triggers a network within the amygdala, thus activating the central nucleus as well. The central nucleus that transmits information to various brainstem centers to evoke three different aspects of emotional responses. Pathways through the periaqueductal gray evoke emotional behaviors. 2. Pathways through the lateral hypothalamus evoke autonomic processes. 3. Pathways through the bed nucleus of the stria terminalis evoke hormonal responses. Learned behaviors are notoriously slow to extinguish. During extinction training, which is the process of removing the association of fear to a neutral stimuli, activity in the prefrontal cortex, which projects to the amygdala, is necessary for the animal to benefit. Absence of one type of the cannabinoid receptors inhibits unlearning similarly, serving as evidence that stimulation of these receptors plays a role in extinguishing learned fears. In humans, visual stimuli associated with pain and fear lead to increased blood flow to the amygdala. People who suffer from temporal lobe seizures that include the amygdala report intense fear heralds the start of a seizure. A subject with a loss of her amygdala caused by a rare genetic disorder exhibits fearlessness from normally fear-inducing stimuli. Despite the central role of the amygdala in fear, both of which this subject is missing, she can be made afraid by such things as being given air with a high concentration of CO2 or when injected with an epinephrine-like drug. This means that the brain has alternative ways of inducing panic. One hypothesis states that the amygdala plays a role in identifying and interpreting external